I mean, to me, it's like we're bombarded here in Southern California. It's not even like one thing. This is what I feel like living in Southern California. This is what it feels like. You know? It's like you're just, oh man. All around. It's like everywhere you turn, it's like, man, something is tempting you. Don't you feel like this? So what do you do? What are we supposed to do when we live in a land where it's like everywhere I turn, it's like something's just grabbing for my attention, trying to pull me away from God, right? It's just crazy. That's the world we live in. And so what do? We close our eyes? You guys want to try to take the hat off? We can run up in the mountains somewhere, start our own little commune and where there's just no temptation allowed. You know, is that the answer? Do we leave the world somehow and get away from what? You can't. Temptation's going to be everywhere. It surrounds us. It's dangling in front of our face every second. And so what do? Here's what we do. You ever have those times where maybe you're driving and you've got to get to a location so fast and you're just looking at the traffic, you're looking at this road, you're looking at red lights, everything else, and you're so focused, and there could be a friend in the car next to you, like waving. Has that ever happened to you? Like, hey, hey, you know, and they tell you later, dude, I was doing everything, I'm honking my horn, you didn't even look. And you go, oh, I'm sorry, I was just so focused. I was just so looking at, I didn't even notice you. I'm so sorry that I blew you off. The Bible says, don't close your eyes to temptation. Don't just keep running from it. The Bible says, fix your eyes. Fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. He says, set your mind on things above, not earthly things. It's the idea of a person being so focused on this love relationship where he's kind of going, I love you, I love you, that you're not even noticing anything else. You don't know what else is going on in the room. You're just so focused on Jesus, so in love and so thinking about eternal things. That's the idea. We can't run from temptation. We can't just keep running our whole lives. We have to run toward Jesus, the author and perfecter. We have to fix our eyes on Him so that all these things are dangling in front of our face, but we don't even notice it because we're so focused. Understand, that is the key to resisting temptation. It's running toward a love of God. That's why the Bible says, look, if you love God, everything's going to be fine. If you love your neighbor as yourself, you can't sin against them. As long as you keep loving, as long as you keep pursuing the things you're supposed to pursue, that's when you don't see the other things because you're focused on the goal. But every once in a while, we see something dangling in front of our eyes, right? And we turn. And the Bible says at that moment, he goes, after that desire, verse 15, he goes, then desire, every once in a while, that desire, it takes. Rather than repulsing, because you have a choice. We all feel it. But the moment you feel that temptation, that's not the sin right there. Because we're going to see things that catch our eye, but the choice then is ours. Do we encourage by staring longer, or do we repulse and run and just focus our eyes on Jesus again?